Moretti. Speed. An inaccurate clearance by White gives Everton possession. Everill. And that's a good run by Ward. He's got Johnston far post. Cotty on the edge of the area. And Beardsley finally has the shot. And it was a tremendous effort from that range. Corner. Beardsley again. Strachan took it off him. Leeds could break here. Cantona in possession and shut ahead of him. And he ran straight into trouble in the shape of Watson. But he's given it away. Still Leeds have a lot of players forward. McAllister tried to curl it then. Everill made a good tackle. Southall in trouble. The shot turns it back in and it's gone in off the defender. Shot claims the goal, but it hit Keown on the goal line and went in, and Leeds United are in front. 13 minutes into the second half.
Well, good forward play by Gary McAllister. Deflection up in the air. And a good challenge by Coulshaw. He's not very big, but makes a great challenge. And he's alert, very sharp onto the ball. And in off Keown for a goal. It's just what the game needed.
Has to go down as an own goal, that. Well, as Coulshaw did here. And I think Southall will be a bit disappointed with himself that he didn't get distance on that attempt to fist it away. Shot just turned it back into the middle. And Keown covering the near post. Well, the ball hit him. He didn't really know much about it. But yes, an own goal.
I think Southall won't be happy with this punch. Completely flapped at it. But Coulshaw was very alert. And I think I'd have to give that to Coulshaw.
That's a typical striker talking, isn't it?
I've got to say that.
Well, whoever it goes to, it's gone to Leeds United. And that's the important thing. And they're in front now. Johnston struggling to win it back off White. And suddenly the pace of the game has picked up, and suddenly Leeds look dangerous again with Carl Schaff here. Southall looked a little slow initially to come out. Strachan beaten to it by Everill. Good work by the Everton midfielder. And then he hits it too deep, does he, or does he? Beardsley's trying to make the most of it. Goal kick. Well, while all that was going on, Everton made a substitution, which I must confess I didn't notice too. In fact, Peter Beagrie has come on. And the players who've gone off are Robert Bashika and Tony Cotty. So both Andy Hinchcliffe and Peter Beagrie have come on for Everton. And that'll cause them to reshuffle things. We'll comment on that in a moment. As Schupp goes through again. And Jackson just whipped the ball away from him. So just looking around quickly, Beardsley has obviously gone up front now, along with Mo Johnson for Everton. Ward has switched back to the right. Beagrie's taken up a position on the left, and Hinchcliffe's gone in midfield.
I must admit, I agree with Brian Robson. I prefer Peter Beardsley to play up front. I feel he's far more dangerous and a greater threat to the opposition team. I'm always glad to see Peter Beardsley playing in midfield. I think he's less of a danger though.
He is, in fact, Everton's leading goal scorer this season as well, with 14. Hasn't missed a game since his move from Liverpool. So a pretty dramatic and instant reconstruction by Howard Kendall the moment Everton went a goal behind. Cantona. Strachan. And Southall always favourite to reach there. From our reporter Gary Newbon on the touchline, that Howard Kendall was going to make those changes regardless of the fact that Leeds United took the lead. They were waiting to come on as the ball hit the net. Faircuff's clearance. Hinchcliffe, one of the substitutes, offside. Johnston's offside. Flag went up instantly. Played since the middle of December. He had a lot of games at the start of the season, including the match against Leeds here in the Rumbelows Cup, which Leeds won 4-1. Gary Speed for Leeds. Goal in front now for McAllister. Speed again. Flying in on that roll. Oh, the smashing little player normally, but just doesn't seem on his game yet. Watson's header, Jackson, under pressure from Speed. Everton get the throw. Here's Ward. Johnston beaten, an excellent tackle too by Fairclough.
Ooh,
yes. Strachan gave it away. Now Hinchcliffe. And Hinchcliffe gives it away. Well, Brian Robson watching in our studio.
Yes, well, I felt that Leeds were always looking a bit dangerous, and Neville Southall will be a bit disappointed about the way he went for the cross, but you know, they got the break that they were looking for, Leeds, and now it should be a really exciting game.
We all hope so. We've waited a long time. Cantona beaten by Watson. Dorigo. On it goes again from Jackson. Lukic in control. Leeds have now scored 28 goals away from home this season. Easily the best total. Here's Strachan. And Cantona. Strachan's gone down injured from that earlier challenge, but play has gone on with Dorigo. Well, that's a good-looking cross by Dorigo. An awkward sort of clearance by Ablett.
That was a terrific ball by Tony Dorigo. It's a striker's dream. Coming in at the far post, it's a certain goal for any striker.
And Ablett had to hack it away for a corner out because Shutt was right behind him. We've seen some spectacular away performances from Leeds this season, with a 4-1 win at Aston Villa and a 6-1 win at Sheffield Wednesday. Gone, it seems, are the days when Leeds would just sit on a one-goal lead away from home. Strachan into that near post, danger zone again. Hinchcliffe gets it away. Beagrie. Carrister wins it back, but the whistle's already gone. Free kick to Everton. Is that part of the policy and philosophy these days at Elland Road, Lee?
We were just told to go out and play. We were not told to defend Leeds. We were told to go out and score another goal. We just enjoy playing, and it's just the joy of playing that makes you go on and get further goals, and I'm sure this is what we'll do today.
In fact, Leeds are the only team in the Football League who've scored four or more goals quite as often as they have, five times this season. Prolific record. Got one precious goal to their credit here today. Everill for Everton. Beardsley. Beagrie took it well on the chest and skips round Strachan. Ablett. Johnston. Oh, great turn by Johnston. Oh, that was vintage Bo Johnston. Leaned into the defender and turned him in one instant and has won the corner. Picked on by Ablett and Jackson! And the youngster hits his first ever goal in league football to bring Everton level. 20 minutes gone in the second half. A moment Matthew Jackson will remember for the rest of his life.
Yes, Leeds won't be happy with the defender here. Two players at the far post queuing up to head the ball in, and only Gordon Strachan marking. Not very good defensively from Leeds. But a great moment for the youngster.
We've said it so often from Leeds' point of view that those near post flick-ons are so difficult to defend, and now they find to their own cost just how difficult. You won't get a closer view than this. And for the first time today, the Everton shouts ringing around Goodison. One each, we've got a game on our hands now. Tony Dorigo for Leeds United. Batty. McAllister. Cantona. Strachan. Bracken gets it back in, then away by Watson. Sterling picking it up again, and a good looking ball towards Shutt, and Jackson does his job well at the other end, and indeed he was being fouled, so he's won the free kick. 20, Matthew Jackson, his first season in the First Division, signed, remember, from Luton Town in October. And a sweet moment that was for him. Johnston, leaning into the defender, I felt then, but the referee is happy for play to go on. Leeds in possession with Lukic. Aggression behind that clearance. Speed control lets him down. That, remember, was Everton's first goal in four matches, scored by this man, Matthew Jackson. Johnston lets it run on here to Beardsley. Berkloff, and then Beardsley comes away, but the whistle had gone. Defenders getting themselves in a good deal of confusion there for a moment, with Beardsley buzzing around. But it was well watched by White. Johnston was in right behind him, if he hadn't got there. His speed. Sweetly now, but offside as Hinchcliffe threaded it through to Johnston. We can have a look, Lee, at the Everton goal from our camera on the other side of the pitch.
Yeah, it's a good flick on, but he's got no one behind him trying to win the ball. We won't be happy with that defensively, that's for sure.
And knowing Howard Wilkinson, we won't be happy. I think it's a bit of an understatement, isn't it?
I would say so.
It well, it's certainly given Everton a lift and an impetus that hadn't been there previously. That goal, Beagrey brought down by Sterling. The referee has gone over as though he's going to caution Mal Sterling for that, and he is. He was pretty quick, Beagrey. When he receives the ball like that and turns the defender, I'm not sure whether it was malicious or just unfortunate on his part, but he was beaten and had already committed himself to the tackle. Let's see.
No, I don't think it was malicious. Mal just mistimed the tackle.
Right in front of the Everton bench. Couldn't have been a worse place. Free kick flicked on. Watson couldn't control it. And Panar breaks clear. It up nicely and then gives it away. About 20 minutes to go here at Goodison Park. It's Everton 1, Leeds United 1. Canister. Keown gets it away, Batty in quickly, McAllister again, and Dorigo wasn't quite as far forward as he imagined. Wood. Beardsley. Looks for Beagrey and finds him with a splendid ball. Good control too by the winger. And a good ball forward for Ablett. In first time towards Johnston, Fairclough read that well. Good play by Leeds, Gary Speed. At the moment, Everton. Everton are just beginning to get the upper hand in this game. Here's Ward. DePaul Johnston takes it in full stretch.